Actor Kunal Nair starred on The Big Bang Theory as astrophysicist Raj Kuthrapali. And while he certainly made a name for himself with 12 seasons of the popular show, we're dishing on his better half, his wife, Neha Kapoor. Kapoor is truly a classic beauty with her sophisticated grace, literate fashion sense, and perfect skin. She stands at an impressive 5'10 and sports a flowing mane of dark hair that frames her elegant face. But surprisingly, she wasn't an outwardly confident schoolgirl back in the day. She told Whereabout, "I was an introvert at school. Most of my time was spent either in the library or in the painting room." While she was able to nurture her creative spirit, it's kind of wild to imagine her not being the center of attention. Kapoor has her suspicions as to why she was the opposite of a social butterfly, adding, "I also stood back in the line at school because I was the tallest. There is a connection. Anyway, it was ridiculous." Clearly, this beauty finally learned to take her space.
"I think the next time I have to speak to a call center in India, I'm going to try using an American accent."
Although Kapoor has moved to Southern California to be with her husband, she's still very fond of her home city of Delhi. She told Whereabout, "I am biased about Delhi. I was born and brought up there. I think it gives one more freedom and space. It is more culturally inclined. And the most you can sit in a traffic jam is 45 minutes, and not 2 hours." Given that LA is infamous for its congested traffic, you know that was a jab at her adopted home. As to where she recommends people travel in her native country, she told the New Potato, "It would be unfair to call out one city that you should see first, as India is so vast and it gives a different experience depending on which part you see first." Even so, she does recommend visiting the Dalai Lama, seeing the Taj Mahal, exploring the Golden Temple in Amritsar, and scoping out the Red Fort, among other destinations. It should come as no surprise that Kapoor was a model for quite a long time. She certainly has both the looks and the height for the profession. She told Whereabout in 2011, "I have done it for 9 years now. After a point, there's everything you've done. So once you're done with all that, and the moment it starts becoming a job, it's time to move on."
"Is this completely going back home and sleeping and getting ready for the next day?"
At the time, she was just about to move to Los Angeles, so she was plotting out what her next career move would be. She added, "I would love to do something in design and art, not clothes. I'd like to get back to maybe studying art again." It sounds like she never lost that creative spirit.
The Pond's Femina Miss India Universe, contestant number 15, Neha Kapoor!
In 2006, Kapoor won Miss India and went on to represent her country at the Miss Universe pageant that year. That's a serious accomplishment, given how competitive pageants are, and it's something she looks back on fondly. She recalled the experience, telling the New Potato, "Miss India was special. Much against my will, my godmother, who was also my agent, made me participate, and it changed my life forever." Of everything that she remembers about the big day, one thing stands out to her as the greatest highlight. She said, "The best memory from that day was winning in front of my parents, my godmother, and all of my closest friends. I will never forget that moment because of the love I felt in the room."
"You realize we're just how incredibly lucky you are as a man. You know?"
Yes.
Sparks flew from the very beginning for Kapoor and Nair, literally from the second they first met. Thanks to a friend, Kapoor happened to be in the right place at the right time. She told Vogue India, "Kunal was visiting India and my friend called me saying, 'Oh, this really great guy is visiting from America.' There was a party at a bar, and I saw Kunal dressed all LA, the star."
"And I was invited to some party, and she was there, and I was like, wow, she's so hot."
Of course, Nair noticed Kapoor's stunning looks and offered to buy her a drink. And that's where their whirlwind romance started. Nair told the outlet, "We sat in a corner at a little table with a candle for 3 hours. It was amazing."
"I'm 5'8 and she's 5'10, but she was wearing 5-inch heels, so she was 6'3. So I was like, sit down, I'll buy you a drink."
After that, they spent every possible minute together until Nair had to go back to Los Angeles 9 days later. Kapoor came to visit him in LA 3 weeks after that, where it became even clearer that their romance was as serious as it gets. In 2011, Kapoor and Nair officially tied the knot. And even though they had been dating since late 2008, Nair was totally blown away when he saw his wife walk down the aisle. He told Vogue India, "My favorite moment was seeing Neha for the first time that day. It still gives me the shivers to think of how beautiful she looked." But Nair wasn't just focused on Kapoor's looks, it was something deeper. He added, "I mean, I obviously know my wife is beautiful. The whole world knows she's beautiful. But there was something more than physical beauty at play when she was walking. It was spiritual. She was a vision. I'll never forget that till the day I die." But Nayer wasn't the only one witnessing the moment. He told Conan of the wedding.
It was 6 days, 1,000 people.
But how can you have 1,000 people?
Because there's like billions of people in India. So it's just my whole neighborhood came to the wedding.
So,
given that the pair opted for a traditional wedding, there were a lot of rituals they had to include as part of the ceremony. That included the groom's entrance to the wedding atop a white horse. And in his case, a skittish horse.
It's like bucking up and down, and I'm thinking, how sad is this? Like, this is the day I'm going to die.
The whole thing may have made Nayer a little nervous, but everything turned out just fine. Once the wedding celebration was over, it was time for Kapoor to move to Los Angeles permanently, and time for Nayer to vacate his bachelor pad in favor of a home they could share together. The newlyweds purchased a 1948 Spanish hacienda, and initially, Nayer was anxious about how they would furnish their new home. He once mused to Architectural Digest, quote, "What will we do with this space?" Fortunately for him, his wife knew exactly what to do. He said, "Neha, being very cultured and having a very good eye, she saw this vision of the place. With the help of designers, they got to work on making their house a home, striving for what Nayer called an amalgamation of the country we live in and the country we're from and the places we've traveled. We want this to be a story of our journey." The couple also prioritized having an indoor-outdoor energy that flowed seamlessly. Kapoor added, "We wanted to have this living, breathing energy, so you see a lot of plants inside, and there's a Buddha inside and outside. Some people need to mix things up in order to be fulfilled, but that's not the case for Kapoor, who told the new potato, "I am a creature of habit. My day usually begins with lighting incense and conducting prayers at the two shrines I have in the house, then making a pot of English breakfast tea with shortbread cookies, and talking with my parents in India. She does all this at 6:30 in the morning, followed by yoga, then breakfast at 10:30. The rest of Kapoor's schedule is also pretty methodical," she added. "I practice yoga 4 times a week, and every 2 hours I get hungry. I spend a lot of my day behind my desk, so I always keep almonds and cranberries handy. Neha, we feel you on those healthy habits." It's impossible to miss that Kapoor is quite the fashionista, stunning every time she hits the red carpet. But it turns out that a lot of that fashion savvy was shaped by her experiences back in her home country. She told the new potato, "I have some of the fondest memories from India Fashion Week. This is where my love for fashion grew, and I made some of the closest friends I have today." For Kapoor, the event is especially inspiring because of the people who attend it, making it quite the style incubator. She added, "It is such a creative space, full of young designers and veterans. It was a great platform to launch into the world of fashion for me, and it continues to grow even today for young talent." In 2014, Kapoor was ready to share her new creative endeavor with the world, and it would be her label, Hensley, that would put her on the map as a bona fide designer. Inspired by her cultural identity, she debuted the brand in the fall of 2016, telling Vogue, "My upbringing was classical in terms of music and Indian dance, how my parents were at home. I wanted to put together something that mixed my Eastern sensibility with something that had a kind of storytelling behind it, because that's what dance is." When it comes to Kapoor's style icon, it all goes back to her roots, her mom. She told the new potato, "You will always find her in the most beautiful saris. Even today, she takes extra care in dressing up. She always has a flower in her hair, and she always matches the color of her bindi to her sari." Clearly, her mom's got it going on in the style department, and she's passed it all on to her daughter.
Biggest splurge.
Oh man, I'm Indian, so I'm such an accountant. But probably all of my wife's jewelry.
For Kapoor, when it comes to food, there's only one thing on the menu that qualifies as her absolute favorite: sushi. She told the new potato, "Sushi for breakfast, sushi for lunch, and sushi for dinner. If it were up to me, I would end every day with sushi." Of course, Kapoor eats more than just sushi. She has granola and yogurt for breakfast and an arugula salad for lunch. She and her husband also enjoy making homemade Indian food, something they both miss from their home country. She said, "I love making simple yellow lentils with basmati white steamed rice and old school dry Indian potatoes. Kunal makes the meanest lamb keema and kebabs. I always overeat when he cooks."
"When I'm coming home from India to America, I stock all Indian pickles, all legally Indian pickles."
You can learn a lot about a person by asking them who they'd invite to dinner, living or dead. So when asked about this in an interview with The New Potato, Kapoor shared, "I would like to invite my late paternal grandfather, who loved to write and was a philosopher, and my maternal grandfather, who was the first lieutenant governor of Delhi, both of whom I never met. I would also invite my husband, Kunal, who I admire, love, and respect immensely." So what would be on the menu for this ultimate feast? She said, "I would definitely cook up a storm of Indian delicacies, or just order in, so I get to spend more time with all of them."
To be around friends, to be around families, those evenings that we have.
Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more list videos about your favorite celebs are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.